Uganda has ratified a number of international and regional treaties and conventions, including the Convention on the Rights of a Child, which legally obliges the state to protect the rights of all children, including the children who are in conflict and contact with the law. Despite all these interventions, thousands of children in Uganda are still facing a number of violations and abuses, as the National Children's Authority revealed.
We are aware that there is a policy at national level that guides us in ensuring that we attain maximum protection for children. Yes, indeed, we have challenges as a country. You must be aware that we have issues like of street children, that is to say children living in street situations. These are attributed to different factors, push and pull factors. But we are saying that having a child on the street is very unfavorable and it's not allowed. In fact, we are sending a clear message that we are supposed not to allow giving out, like for example, money to children on the streets, because we shall be encouraging children to stay on the streets. But other than we need to address issues that could have them withdrawn and reintegrated back to their communities.
Child wellness experts highlight a number of aspects that can be adopted to ensure that children are brought up in a child-friendly, healthy and safe environment.
The schools are overwhelmed. I don't know if the schools are being assessed. The government asked all schools to have counselors on board, but because of the extra payment, some schools are not doing it. But this is the question. I'm a mother of three teenagers. If my three teenagers can overwhelm me, imagine the teacher who is at a ratio of 100 children per teacher. What do you think is happening back there?
We need fathers to be brought on board. It is unfortunate that at one point, you will find traces of fathers who are not contributing to the well-being of a child. You heard of issues raised here, like coming up on a stage of prenatal, whereby you find that fathers maybe have played a negative role towards the well-being of children. So the appeal here is made clear that we need collective parental responsibility.
Uganda has one of the youngest population in the world, with more than half of its population being children. Despite presence of child-friendly laws and policies, a huge percentage of children are exposed to evils like child labor, child trafficking, child marriage, among others.